Good morning. It's me, Mikey Pipes, with Daniel. We're at a Rheem. I believe this is a 3-ton R410A system. This is the condenser, right? And the customer has complained that it sometimes when it's warm out, it doesn't cool properly. We're just gonna make this quick and short for you, ladies and gentlemen. A good technician is observant of his surroundings. Ain't that right, Peter? Yep. Ain't that right, Daniel? Now, one of the first things I like to do when I get to a service call is, A, I always ask the right questions because your homeowners, your customers, your clients have offer a plethora of information that you can use and help diagnosing a system. Here, the customer was complaining that this weekend it wasn't working. So we turned it off, he turned it back on some short period of time later, and voila, it started working. That doesn't mean there's not something wrong, but Daniel just hooked up his S-Man refrigeration manifold gauges to the system. Before I even look at that, I am gonna be observant of my surroundings.
Now let me show you this, ladies and gentlemen. She's wearing a fur coat. She's wearing a fur coat. You're just gonna sit there and look pretty? No, but.
How are our pressures?
Yeah. Yeah, almost freezing up.
Well, and that was just this side. I wonder how the other side looks. Not terrible, but not clean. Oh yeah, it's horrible actually. Wow. All right, Daniel, you know what to do. So the first thing we're gonna do, we are gonna pull the disconnect, right? And there's one right way of doing this, ladies and gentlemen. You take your left hand behind your back and you use your right hand and you pull the disconnect out. I'm gonna show you, Daniel's gonna show you right now. Daniel's taking his left hand, because his heart is here, behind his back like that, and he's gonna pull it out with his right hand, and voila. God forbid there was a short there. The electricity is gonna travel through his arm, down his right side of his body, down his leg into the earth, sparing his heart. Well, at least in theory, all right? That is how you pull a disconnect, ladies and gentlemen. Okay? Now that the system is powered off, we're gonna leave our gauges hooked up for a while and see how quickly they balance themselves out. Hopefully there's no a freezing condition on the evaporator coil, but we wanna be observant of that. Now, these reams are really, really, really nice to take apart and clean. We can fully disassemble this bad boy by just removing a few screws. We're gonna remove all the screws on the top part holding the condenser top with the fan motor, right? And then there's a couple right there, one there and one there. Voila. Okay. All right, so we are brushing down the condensing coil. Daniel's not wearing his PPE or PPP. A lot of dust and dirt on there, and that's going to affect system performance, right? If you're not able to extract the heat or not be able to exchange heat from that hot coil with those hot gases flowing through it or that hot liquid flowing through it, right? Sorry, liquid. Right? High pressure, high temperature liquid flowing through that evaporator coil and being discharged out by the means of the condenser fan, you are going to have extended runtime, you're going to have extended wear and tear on your components, and you're going to decrease efficiency. So you have extended runtime, accelerated wear and tear, decrease efficiency, right? Because the system could be running for hours and never, ever, ever get the temperature because of a dirty condensing coil. Right, the condensing coil. This is the location where the hot refrigerant, a high pressure, high temperature refrigerant, right before it leaves here, right, is cooled off. And I'm saying it wrong, but you have hot refrigerant flowing through here, right? And the fan runs. The fan runs on top of it. That ambient temperature air is flowing through it. And that it, as the air flows through it, the air becomes, you know, extracts the heat from that refrigerant and discharges at the top. If the coil is dirty, you're not gonna have that heat exchanging going on. Look at that, he's just brushing it off. And it wasn't really a genuine mink fur coat, one that my wife would wear, for example, but it's damn well close. It's like a beaver coat. Beaver. Daniel, like beavers?
No.
You like you have snakes and rabbit, and not rabbits. You have rodents.
Two gerbils.
Gentlemen, just behave yourself with the comments. Daniel likes gerbils. So you have two gerbils. You have a pussycat?
Yeah.
You have a pussycat, don't you? Do you like pussycats?
I do like cats.
He's not going to say pussycats. Why would you say pussycats?
Yeah,
okay.
And a bunch of fish.
And he's
got a frog yesterday.
A frog?
Yeah.
Where'd you get the frog from? The pet store?
Yeah. For the fish tank. It only lives in water. So it just swims its
way. You should have a Daniel's Zoo channel. You ever think about that? It could be DZ or DCZ for your initials. Daniel Zoo. I cracked myself up. All right, so right now we have Peter giving the system a nice thorough rinse with some fresh water, cold water. I heard that, you know, using hot water would help better, but we don't usually have that luxury. Unless you're working at my house and use the outdoor hose faucet.
Hot water?
Yeah. One by my shower, by the hot tub. I have an outdoor shower.
Oh, so not the one I need.
Not the one. Not right next to the condensers, no.
That
would have been pretty cool, right? Use nice hot water. Coming pretty cool.
Did you see the video?
Of yours?
Did I post it?
You did post it, but I have not watched it. So, for chemical cleaning.
Yeah.
For chemical cleaning, we're going to use the Viper. Now, this is the brightener cleaner. It works way better. Works way better than the Venom pack, the yellow one. But this is by Refrigeration Technologies right there. Not a sponsor of the channel. Why not? I have no idea. Why don't they want to sponsor my channel? Join Bosch and HIK Micro and Elitech. I need to get like a big name.
HVAC Cool. Just get a review of all their products. They also have like in a bag all purpose cleaner. So you can just fill up like spray bottles.
Oh yeah? Oh. And you can see Peter's getting his boots wet. Are your toes wet yet?
No, these boots hold up.
They're watertight?
Decently. And right back in the electrical
department. What did he do?
I did this. It's just ripped.
No, it's not.
I almost get so clean.
Why?
Because I don't want to get that wet.
You don't want to get I don't blame you. I don't blame you. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that would suck. All the way up there. That would suck. That would really suck.
It's like the most tight attic in the world.
I know. But Peter is diligently pre-rinsing the condensing coil with fresh water. Nice. Very, very nice.
That.
Peter, you're doing a great service for the client. You know that?
Yeah.
Don't worry, you're not getting any raise anytime soon.
But. I figured, yeah.
You just got one. You got to wait. But ladies and gentlemen, take the covers off. Take a look at the coil. If it's dirty or it's not dirty. If it hasn't been rinsed in a year or two, or you live in a very dusty, dirty area, you know, urban area, it's time to give it a clean. Make it part of your routine preventative maintenance procedures when you're doing preventative maintenance and cleaning of a system.
Same as if you dilute with water and use B or something, or C.
So you like E works best for you?
Yeah.
I've had great success with setting A on the new Calgon coil. But, you know, but listen, if it works good for you, that's fine. But when you put it on A, you really have to move quick. Because you'll empty that whole container in like 30 seconds. But now, Peter is working with the Refrigeration Technologies Viper Venom Pack, the brightener, coil brightener. He's already got this side. And you can see it's bubbling through the unit. See? It's bubbling and it's cleaning. Restoring this coil to practically brand new. Look at that. Very, very nice. Let's go Bosch, ladies and gentlemen. Working through that coil. Look at that. Amazing.
Oh yeah, you can see how dirty it already got.
Look at that. Look at that dirt. Just foaming away. Foaming away.
Wow.
Wow. Epic.
This stuff's definitely way better.
Than the yellow packet. What about then What's that? The gallon buckets that we had last year.
I don't think anything's better than that. But that burns.
That's a burn.
I got that on my skin. It was like
He had like third degree burns.
It was somewhere in his van, and I touched something that had that. My skin like broke out.
I think it's what was it? New Calgon was it the true blue? No, something blue.
I think they just called it condenser coil cleaner.
Blue bright. That's what it's called. The new Calgon blue bright. That stuff burns like a mother effer. That is brutal.
It works so well.
It does work very well. Okay. So we're going to let this sit in for a little while, and then we'll rinse and put all the panels back together. I wonder if he's going to fill it with, are you going to fill it with water? So you can spray some fresh water through it?
Oh yeah.
You don't usually do that?
Usually just while it's off.
Oh yeah. So I normally fill it with like water halfway just to rinse fresh water through. If you use the new Calgon, the True Blue, the Blue Brighter, you'll kill that thing overnight. It'll be dead.
That's scary.
It's acid, straight acid. That will straight up kill coils. See, you had a little bit of soapy come out of there, right? Rubber ducky, you're the one. You make bath time lots of fun. See? Now it's nice and quick. Okay. So now we could rinse the condensing coil. Now we already did a pre-rinse, but let's see if we get any cocky coming out of this coil. Oh, it's not clear.
Yeah.
There you go. Look at that. See? See, ladies and gentlemen, you don't got a clean coil, no bueno. No bueno. So clean your coil.
So I found out why people say you should rinse it from bottom to top.
Tell me why.
Because if you rinse from top to bottom,
yeah, all
you
the dirt,
a lot of the soap out of the bottom part. So by the time you get to the bottom,
I was thinking that all the dirt's gonna make its way down. But you also get rid of the chemical from it by the water dripping down it. Okay, makes sense. So this is the coil brightener. Does it look that much more brighter? Keep it real. I don't think it looks brighter at all.
I think it does.
I don't know.
Maybe I just stink. But with the yellow stuff, I really felt like it looked bad afterwards.
But we're going to get this coil clean and start her up. Move on to the next. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to poll the audience. I want to get some feedback. How many of you guys, I know 50% of the viewers of this channel are in the trades, and maybe half are also in the HVAC trade as well. How many of you actually clean the coils once a year? How many of you do it? If you're not cleaning those coils once a year, you're doing a disservice for your client, right? Check the coils, clean them. Even if they look clean, you should still give them a rinse because you never know. You never know, right? Before it turns into a fur coat, those inside of those coil fins, they actually clog up. They clog up. And then you get the fur coat. All right, so check your coils. Mikey Pipes signing off. And until next time, be well, God bless, stay safe.